Hello and welcome back to another episode of Toy Therapy. I'm the host, the Toy Therapist, aka Matthew Grant, and today, as you can see, I'm looking at another Star Wars Black Series figure. I'm getting through my old backlog at the moment, so bear with me, I'm getting slowly up there, up to date on my figures. As you can see, I'm looking at Padme Amidala, or Senator Amidala. This particular character I actually do like in the actual films, really enjoy, and I like Natalie Portman as well. I think she's a very good actress, and just being a really good character, and she really comes into her own more in the Clone Wars series. You would think she would be like the old damsel in distress. Nope, she is quite the opposite. So a very good character. But anyway, enough about that. Let's get around the box. So you get a nice picture there of Natalie Portman there, which is actually not a bad likeness. And it's number 81. And if you want to read the blurb on the back, so get that in for you, you can. But anyway, let's get to the figure. So I've taken out the sides of the packaging, and this figure is really nice. I'm not a big fan of the old... of the like rubbery type cloth capes. I am going to look into maybe getting that replaced, maybe, and have a look around to see if I can get something and swap it over. But for the moment, though, it will do. It does come with a couple accessories. It comes with a blast up pistol, very, very small dinky, which is quite cute. You're getting an extra hand, which I thought I put onto the blaster. And you should know your blasters. This is what the separatist clankers use, or the robots would use. Roger, roger. And yeah, and this is a really nice paint finish. Really, really nice. And the hand does come off and come back on quite easily as well. So I quickly demonstrate that now. But because the two hands, because it's two different weapons, this particular blaster fits really nicely in that hand. But I still think, yeah, it's a bit loose in that hand. So, yeah, it's going to come out. But, yeah, so you can see the reason why they got two hands. So this will just twist and, oh, God. Might need a little bit of hot water to sort of bring that out, which I won't do because I don't want to break it. But, yeah, so you just pop that off, pop that on. Okay. So let me just go around the figure. So posability. Okay, so you get a nice head movement, goes all the way around. You are getting a really nice arm movement that does go all the way around. Okay, and you're getting a bit of an elbow joint swivel there. And this one is a bit restricted unless you pull that to one side, the cloak, and it will go all the way around as well. Okay, and there we go, and same there as well. So put that down, and this pistol does slot in the holster, which is really quite nice, and it does slot in there really quite nice. That is a bit loose for my liking, but it's still fine. You are getting a nice little twist there, and you're not getting any extra at all there. You're just getting just like the midriff sort of thing there. That's all you're getting. Okay, you are getting some nice leg movements. It's a bit... She goes far up, but she doesn't go all the way forwards. There's very little play here, which is actually quite bad. But you are getting nice sort of splits there. You are getting a very stiff thigh swivel. And as well, you are getting a really good knee joint as well. The pegs are nicely done as well. So they are quite small. They are quite hidden, except for with the boot and things like that. That could have been a little bit painted. Just a little bit, which is the only drawback to it. And as well, the foot, you do get a bit of a swivel and up and down movement as well. But because with women characters, I always find them to be a bit, you know, to be a bit, you want to be extra careful with them, especially with the old hands. So I'm going to look into maybe soften mine up so I can pop that off as well. But overall, for me at the moment, like I said, I'm not a fan of this, but it's got a nice texture to it. They could have done it as an actual material if they really wanted it to, but I'm happy all around all with around with the figure. But for me at the moment, it's all about that head sculpt. That head sculpt is absolutely on point. Mine has a little bit of a blemish here and there, a little bit of a sort of point there, which I can easily sort of take off and redo the ear there. But other than that, though, it's a very good likeness for Natalie Portman as well. I think it's much better than the second Thor movie that they released when they did a Natalie Portman figure then for the Marvel Select, and that didn't look great. This is definitely one of the best ones I've seen in a long, long time. But overall, really, really good. I am going to upgrade that and looking to do something with the hands. But other than that, she is a very good action figure. I'm glad I got her. She only cost me about £15, I believe. But yeah, really, really happy with this figure. Thanks very much for watching my content. Please give me a like, share, subscribe. And as well, remember, just drop me a comment or two. It'd be good to talk to you. And that is it for today. And hopefully you'll see some more figures reviews come out soon and steady. So thank you very much for watching. Take care. Be safe. Bye-bye.